everyone, it's Kendall here and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you what I packed for a 1 month long stay in Bali in this bag. Okay, so I wasn't actually able to pack in just this one bag. Last year, I was able to fully backpack in one bag for 6 weeks, and it was super easy. However, this year, I also went to Japan beginning of my trip, and I needed to pack for different types of weather because it was raining there, and I wasn't sure how cold it was gonna be. So I needed a bigger bag for jeans, jackets, sweaters, and all of that kind of stuff. But I did pack a duffel bag with me because I knew when I got to Bali, I wanted to travel lighter, so I was able to just pick the stuff that I wanted for Bali and put it all in this one bag, and I left my suitcase at my friend's house in Bali. And now I'm going to show you exactly what you need to bring when traveling to Bali, and honestly, it's not that much. So I only packed basics that will go with everything, and then I bought a lot of cute stuff while I was here. All right, so let's dig into this bag. All right, so I'm just going to start by opening the bag and pulling the stuff out. Okay, so for shoes, I only packed 4 pairs of shoes, a pair of flip-flops, which I've honestly pretty much only worn these the entire time. Must bring flip-flops to Bali. You're on a beach and it's hot out, so pretty much you're only gonna be wearing these. I also packed a pair of tennis shoes in case I were to go hiking or for when I go work out. There's a lot of fitness studios here in Bali, so you're gonna wanna bring shoes as well so you can work out and go hiking in the mountains. For cuter shoes, I only brought these two. They're literally the same pair of shoe in different colors, black and tan, and this is what I wear going out. Going out in Bali is super casual. I could literally wear this outfit with these shoes and be totally fine, and they're super small and easy to pack, so honestly, you don't need much in terms of shoes. Just be comfortable and casual and just really dig into that island vibe, you know? All right, for shorts, I also didn't pack that much either. I packed 2 pairs of denim shorts, the ones I'm wearing now. And I also brought these longer biker shorts. It's really nice to have longer shorts when you're traveling because when riding scooters, the seat gets really hot, so it burns your butt. Kind of random, but this helped a lot from not getting my butt burnt. Also, it's just nice to have longer shorts when you're hiking and when you're doing things more in the outdoors. Then I also packed a couple of flowy, comfortable shorts because that's pretty much all you're gonna wear here because it's very hot. So you want to be very cool and comfortable. So I packed these cute little shorts, these black shorts with white flowers, these lighter pair of shorts. They're basically the same style as these. And then I also brought some cuter, it's like a skirt, so they're not really shorts, but shorts in the back, skirt in the front, something a little fancier if I want to go out. I also went shopping for new pants and shorts. So I got these black shorts here in Bali, these white shorts at a cute store in Canggu. And then I also bought a skirt from another little cute store in Canggu. It's long in the front and short on the sides and like that perfect island vibe that I wanted to go for. And I'm wearing it tonight for Halloween. Okay, for pants, I didn't bring any jeans to Bali. I brought jeans to Japan, obviously, because I needed to wear them around the city, but I left them in the suitcase. So in terms of pants, I brought these flowy, tropical, island vibe pants. How many times have I said island vibe in this video? Island vibe. Island vibe.
Island vibe.
Island vibe pants. Anyways, I brought these pants. I have only worn them once just because it's so hot at night that I haven't needed to wear pants. And I also brought these other yellow pants that I've worn a lot on my last trip as well. But they got super muddy, so I left them in the other suitcase. Okay, that's it in terms of pants. And let's get into the tops I brought. For tops, I also didn't pack that much. I just brought a lot of basics. I brought 2 basic white tank tops that I could wear with anything. This basic white tank top from Brandy Melville and this other kind of cuter crop top that I could wear out at night with a tie in the front. I also brought 2 short sleeve white tops just because sometimes you want to cover your shoulders when you're riding a scooter because the sun is beating down on you, and I've gotten sunburnt way too many times. So this is good for skin protection and you can just wear it on the plane and to be comfortable. And it's just good to have some basic white t-shirts. I brought 1 black tank top to go out at night, and I'm actually going to be wearing this for my Halloween costume tonight. And then another green tank top just to wear, just to have. I also brought this cuter top to wear at night. It is a white mesh key top with ties on the top. Super cute and goes with literally everything. And I also bought a few tops while I was here. So I bought this cheetah top to go out at night. It was from a store called Missing in Chengdu. They have the cutest stores here. And I think it was like $15. And I also bought this really cute crocheted shell top. It's off-white and also goes with everything. And I've been wearing this a lot out as well. All right, that's it for tops. And now I'm gonna show you what I brought for bikinis. Normally I would pack a shit ton of bikinis, but I wanted to pack light and I knew that I wanted to get more bikinis while here, and some companies are sending me bikinis to take photos of, so I didn't want to pack too many bikinis. So I brought a lot of just basic solid colors, and I brought bikinis that I haven't worn in photos before so that I can get new photos, and I brought bikinis that'll be comfortable and good for tanning. So I packed a basic white bikini, cute with a cutout in the middle, and the bottoms are Brazilian style, high rise, small on the back, perfect for tanning. I also brought some really colorful bikinis as well. So I brought orange for a pop of color and red because it goes with everything. And these are both from TJ Swim. And I also brought this bikini. It is a striped bikini from Monse Swim with really cute cutouts on the side. And the top is a tube top and doubles as a shirt. So I've literally been wearing this as a top throughout the day. And it's nice because it's bikini material, so I'm sweating all day in it. Doesn't show. And I also brought this basic turquoise bikini that I've had for so long, and it's honestly really old. And I didn't bring it for photos. I mostly brought it because it's comfortable and it's good for tanning. All right, so that's all the bikinis I brought, and I'm planning on getting more bikinis from the stores around here because they're super cheap, and getting more bikinis from other brands. In terms of workout gear, I only brought two outfits just to save some room. You're gonna be doing a lot of yoga and working out in Bali and hiking, so you wanna bring things that will work for everything. So I brought these Nike Pro spandex that I literally wear all the time when working out. Super easy, really lightweight and easy to pack. And I brought a basic black sports bra to go with it. I also packed some aloe biker shorts because I wanted a longer option. I didn't have room for full-on yoga pants, and also it's way too hot for that, and I hate having to squeeze into them. So I just brought these biker shorts that have been working really well. Also, if you don't wanna wear booty shorts, because sometimes I feel uncomfortable walking around in booty shorts, so I'll wear these longer shorts because they're a little bit more protective and good for yoga as well. And it comes with a matching cute little sports bra top. Just brought these two for working out and my workout shoes that you saw earlier. All right, in terms of underwear and sleeping clothes, so I only packed one sleep shirt because I knew I was going to be buying more shirts when I got to Vietnam and Japan, and I also steal my boyfriend's shirts. So I only really needed to pack one sleep shirt. And then I packed these really comfortable white shorts that I can wear around the villa and at night. Usually I only sleep in underwear, so I don't really sleep in these, but just if I wanna walk outside and be comfortable, I brought these. For underwear, I brought enough underwear for 10 days. I would bring as much underwear as you can fit, but don't overdo it because there are laundry services here for super cheap, so you can just wash your underwear if you run out. Then I also brought two bras, one black and one tan bra. I haven't really been wearing them at all here. I literally haven't needed a bra at all. I've been going braless and it's so comfortable. It's also way too hot to wear a bra. So I would say you don't really need to wear a bra, but if it's something you want to bring, then go for it because it's small enough to just throw in your suitcase. In terms of jackets and sweats, I only brought one pair of sweats, and literally it's only to wear on the plane to be comfortable because planes are really cold, and especially for a 10 to 15 hour flight, you want to be comfortable. And then I only brought one gray sweater to wear on the plane as well. I haven't worn any jackets while here in Bali. It's so hot that you're not gonna need it. Okay, so that's it in terms of the clothes I packed. As you can see, I packed very light. I brought about 4 to 5 t-shirts, 2 denim shorts, 3 comfortable shorts, 4 bikinis, 10 days worth of underwear, 2 pairs of nice sandals, pair of flip-flops, and workout shoes. And really, that is all you need when you're in Bali because you're gonna be shopping a lot, it's so hot, and you wanna leave room in your suitcase for new outfits. Okay, so now on to makeup and toiletries. I really didn't pack much for makeup because it is so hot here, like I've said 1,000 times already, that you're just gonna sweat your makeup off and you don't wanna be wearing it anyways because you're just gonna break out. So I haven't been wearing makeup this entire time I'm here during the day. Sometimes I will put it on for videos like this or for photo shoots or to go out at night, but mostly, most of my photo shoots have been without makeup and I've just been taking really good care of my skin while here. Basically, I only really packed, let's see, got some concealer in here, some tinted moisturizer, mascara, eyelash curler, lipstick, eyebrow brush. I also brought eyeliner and eyeshadow just in case I was to do a full-on photo shoot, but I honestly haven't been wearing those at all while here. So I packed very light in terms of makeup. And then for toiletries, I brought these travel-size skincare products from Facial Works. They're absolutely amazing and they fit in your carry-on. So I brought some facial cleanser and toner, and I also brought some moisturizer because you need to hydrate while you're in the sun all day. I also brought Facial Works Beach Please sunscreen. It's SPF 55 and I've been wearing this every single day. It also fights against acne, so it has ingredients in there to help clear your acne because sunscreen can be really damaging to your skin. So I've been literally wearing this every day and nothing else. I also brought a toothbrush and toothpaste, but have just been buying new ones every 2 weeks. And I've just been buying shampoo and conditioner while here in small packages because they have everything you need here at the store, so there's no reason to add weight to your bag and bring extra things. I would say that you can buy most of your basic toiletries here, like shampoo, conditioner, body wash, razors, toothbrush, toothpaste, and just bring your skincare products or any other products that you need to have that you can't find here. But basically, you can find a lot of brands like Pantene and Tresemme here in Bali, and it's super easy to find and it's very cheap. One thing of body wash was 50 cents. 50 cents. Crazy. I also packed this backpack that I've been wearing everywhere. This backpack fits literally everything, so I'll show you what I brought. I brought my computer, obviously, and my hard drive because I'm doing a lot of editing while here. I also bought my camera, which I'm filming on right now with the speaker above it. I got this little case for my camera, super tiny and small, and it can fit in my bag and in my other smaller bag. Speaking of the smaller bag, I brought a tiny little backpack to bring with me on daytime adventures when I don't want to bring this giant backpack, so this has been really good. I also wear this out at night sometimes, and I only brought one purse as well, just a black purse that goes with everything that's small and can fit everywhere in my bag. You don't really need to be that fancy in Bali, so I didn't bring any purses, and I'm not a purse person either. Like, I don't really care about purses, so just brought these two bags. All right, back to my backpack. I also brought my notebook that I have been doing a lot of work in, a lot of brainstorming for my business. I brought my journal to do my morning journaling, manifestations, and meditation reflections. For books, I also brought this book, I'm reading The Untethered Soul. And I brought my Kindle, of course, because it's small and I can take it anywhere with me. Also, I brought chargers, obviously, for my computer, my camera, my phone, my Kindle. I also brought some portable chargers to take with me on day adventures for my phone when it runs out of battery. And then I brought the obvious little things such as converters for your chargers and AirPods. All right, so that is all I packed for Bali in these two bags. I hope it was helpful for you and that you know what you need to pack when you come to Bali in the future, which definitely come to Bali because it's amazing. Anyways, thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, give it a like. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel, Kendall Furman, for more videos in the future about traveling, about tips for mindfulness, productivity, and just videos about my life in general. All right, see you next time.